sometimes I get ridiculous. I'll eat up all your crackers and your licorice. Oh, yo, fat girl, come here, are you ticklish? Yeah, I got
that. Coming up next, Digital Underground. We'll be back with more Video Soul in a couple of minutes. I once got busy in a bathroom. I'm crazy. Allow me to amaze thee. They say I'm ugly, but it just don't faze me. I'm still getting in the girl's pants, and I even got my own. There's still one of the hottest songs in the country. It's done by Digital Underground. That's Digital Underground. The tune, of course, is Humpty Dance, taken from the album Sex Packets on Video Soul.
You're doing, cause I'm about to ruin the image and the style that you're used to. I look funny, but yo, I'm making money, see? So yo, world, I hope you're ready for me. Now gather round, I'm the new fool in town, and my sound's laid down by the underground. I drink a ball of Hennessy you got on your shelf, so just let me introduce myself. My name is Humpty, pronounced with the umpty. Yo, ladies, oh, how I like to funk thee. And all the rappers in the top 10, please allow me to bump thee. I'm stepping tall, y'all, and just like Humpty Dumpty, you're gonna fall when the stereos pump me. I like to rhyme, I like my beats funky, I'm spunky. I like my oatmeal lumpy, I'm sick with this. Straight gangster Mac. But sometimes I get ridiculous. I'll eat up all your crackers and your licorice. Oh, yo, fat girl, come here, are you ticklish? Yeah, I called you fat. Look at me, I'm skinny. It never stopped me from getting busy. I'm a freak. I like the girls with the boom. I once got busy in a bathroom. I'm crazy. Allow me to amaze thee. They say I'm ugly, but it just don't faze me. I'm still getting in the girls' pants, and I even got my own dance.
Come on, I do the Humpty Hump.
Check me out, y'all.
I do the Humpty Hump.
Just watch me
do the Humpty Hump.
Yeah. Do you know what I'm doing? Doing the Humpty Hump. Come on.
I do the Humpty Hump. I do the Humpty Hump.
People say, yo, Humpty, you're really funny looking. That's alright, cause I get things cooking. You stare, you glare, you constantly try to compare me. But you can't get near me. I'm giving more C, and on the floor B, all the girls, they adore me. Oh yes, ladies, I'm really being sincere. Cause in the 69, my Humpty nose will tickle your rear. My nose is big. I'm not ashamed, big like a pickle. I'm still getting paid, I get laid by the ladies. You know I'm in charge, both how I'm living and my nose is large. I get stupid, I shoot an arrow like Cupid. I use a word that don't mean nothing, like Luke did. I sang on Do What You Like, and if you missed it, I'm the one who said, just grab them in the biscuits. Also told you that I like to bite. Well yeah, I guess it's obvious, I also like to write. All you had to do was give Humpty a chance, and now I'm gonna do my dance.
The Humpty dance is your chance to do the hump.
Come on.
Do the Humpty Hump,
sexy baby. Everybody, come on and do the Humpty Hump. Oh, do you know what we're doing the Humpty Hump, y'all.
Oh, do the Humpty Hump,
watch me do the Humpty Hump. Ah, yeah, that's the break, y'all. Let a little of that bass groove right here. Do real, do real, do real, do real. Ah, yeah. Now that I told y'all a little bit about myself, let me tell you a little bit about this dance. It's real easy to do. Check it out. First I limped to the side like my leg was broken. Shaking and twitching, kinda like I was smoking. Crazy, whack, funky. People say you look like MC Hammer on crack, Humpty. That's alright, cause my body's in motion. It's supposed to look like a fit or a convulsion. Anyone can play this game. This is my dance, y'all. Humpty Hump's my name. No two people will do it the same. You got it down when you appear to be in pain. Humping, funking, jumping, gig around, shaking your rump. And when a doodoo chump punk points a finger like a stunt, tell him step off, I'm doing the hump.
The Humpty dance is your chance to do the hump.
Everybody,
do me, baby.
I do the Humpty Hump.
Come on,
I do the Humpty Hump.
Sexy lady,
I do the Humpty Hump. I do the Humpty Hump.
Do the Humpty Hump.
I do the Humpty Hump.
Black people,
I do the Humpty Hump.
I've been sweating you just a bit too long. I've given you everything, Angela. But you keep running those stupid games. But guess what, baby? You just played yourself. Are you listening to me? Yeah, I guess those batteries went dead on that hearing aid I bought you, you mop head.
Yo, baby, check it out. You been dogging. Dogging me hard.
Just attacking
up
a
hunch. I ain't ready. Shit. Come on. I ain't sweating no more, baby. Let's go.
My love, and all I do is sweat, scratch my head and worry. See, only heaven knows, girl, I'm playing your game, and the rules are anything goes. So I always keep one eye on ya, never know what you'll do. Love is not a game, why must I sweat on you? Playing your silly games, girl, you must think it's cool. Love is not a game, why must I sweat you? Just what you expect. Sometimes I hate to be with you, coach, you give me no respect. You flirt and play nonchalant, just a way to get me vexed. Don't blame me for a fool, cause I ain't been played yet. Your eyes wander everywhere. Sometimes I wonder if you care. You say you love me, but if it were true, girl,
hey, don't go away. We'll be back in a couple of minutes with more Video Soul.
My shoes are on, baby. I'm out the door. Last chance. I ain't gonna be around. I'm out of here. I ain't sweating you no more. Later.
Next on Video Soul, we have the group Whistle. We've done a remake of Heatwave. tune, and they did a good job on it too. It's not easy to redo a song like that, but these fellas put a hurting on it. Here they are with Always and Forever on Video Soul.
Somehow came true, and I know tomorrow will still be the same, 'cause we got a life of love that won't ever change. And every day, love me your own special way. Melt all my my heart.
every day my imagination anticipates ways I can show you how much I love you. Candy flowers, priceless pearls, romantic trips about the world. Baby, just think, you and me
We'll be back in a couple of minutes. Don't go away. Coming up next, Quincy Jones with Tevin Campbell. Quincy Jones is on a roll, isn't he? Like a 40-year roll. Currently, he's in the studio working vigorously with Tevin Campbell on his solo album, and I can't wait to see what they come out of the studio with. Anyway, we're going to take a look at Quincy and Tevin now with Tomorrow on Video Soul.
Belongs to you, that's all around with me. good ain't around me. Somewhere that I can't see. You and me were meant to be. That's alright with me.
Classic video, Janet Jackson along with Heavy D and Cab Calloway on Video Soul. I'm Donnie Simpson. We'll be back with the second hour of the show in just a couple of minutes. Don't go away. Welcome back to the second hour of Video Soul. I'm Donnie Simpson, and in this hour of Video Soul, we're going to see videos by Smokey Robinson. We got a brand new one from Barbara Weathers, who used to be the lead singer for Atlantic Star. And we're going to spend some time with saxophonist extraordinaire, George Howard. He's released a new album, a new video, and I understand he's going to play a tune or two for us. It'll be up in just a little bit right here on Video Soul. Right now, we're going to take a look at Melba Moore and Lift Every Voice and Sing.
To live, to love, and to give. There's one thing greater, to open up your heart and let it sing. There's no wall, no barrier of resistance that can stop the tumultuous tide of everlasting hope. So through it all, keep hope alive. All over the world, as the walls crumble, hope rises. Nelson Mandela glories in the words, in the beat, in the melody, in the joy, in the victory, in the conquest. There's no turning back. Let freedom ring. Lift every voice and sing until the power comes down. Let the power come down.
Let it resound, loud as a rolling sea.
hope alive. Keep hope.
George Howard coming up in a couple of minutes. Don't go away. Welcome back to Video Soul. I'm Donnie Simpson. I'm joined now by saxophonist George Howard. He's from West Philly, and he's here. This man's played with the best. He's been around Grover Washington Jr., George Duke, Larry Blackmon, and the list goes on. He played with himself mostly. That's been his biggest success. Well, I didn't mean to phrase it quite like that. His eyebrows raised on that one. I had the pleasure of welcoming him to Video Soul. the one and only George Howard. He's going to perform something for us right now from his new album called Personal. This is called You and Me on Video Soul.
You and me, in love we will be. You and me.
Thank you.
That's fantastic, man.
Thank you.
Oh, who taught you how to play?
I did, Donnie.
Really?
No.
No. I believe you.
I'm self-taught on saxophone. Mm-hmm. I studied when I was beginning with a lady named Shirley Curtis on clarinet and bassoon, and I studied the classics and played oboe. Mm-hmm. And, you know, basically playing Vivaldi and Chopin, all those folks.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, what took you from that to jazz?
I got really bored playing the classics, even though it was good for the discipline and learning the fundamentals of all the instruments and what have you. I used to get really bored, and I say a lot, but, I mean, these people have been dead for 400 or 500 years, man.
Yeah.
And I just wanted to, you know.
Do something like, a little more current.
Yeah, you know. You don't see them on the charts or anything.
No, I haven't. Not recently, anyway. Not on the charts I watch.
No, no.
I don't know about the classical charts, but so how do you learn the soul that I hear? I mean, you know, I hear a lot of people play saxophone, but you have such feeling with it. Is that something that is taught, or is that just something that you're born with?
No, I think that's something that you're born with. And that you develop through your life's experiences. When you listen to some of the great players like David Sanborn and people like Grover and Wayne Shorter, I mean, you know that they've lived a lot to say what they've said, you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
And the same with Miles, and I could go on and on. And if you haven't lived anything, if you haven't been anywhere, if you haven't had anything happen to you, so to speak, then I don't think you have anything to say.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't think it's, you know, really that unique. It's just relating your life's experiences to your instrument.
But it's through your instrument. I mean, when you're dealing with a song with lyrics, most of what you do is instrumental. It's very easy. You can read the lyrics. I mean, they write them right on the albums right now. But in listening to, what does this song say to us, you and me, the song you just played?
Well, when I first heard the song, you know, I felt a kinship with it. I mean, I felt like it was something that I could have written myself, even though I didn't.
Mm-hmm.
And it just reminds me of relationships and relating to people. And one of the most challenging things about instrumental music, knowing that the layman or the average person doesn't really understand all that goes behind what you do or how long you've practiced or, you know, just don't understand the language of music itself, is really a challenge to reach these people, because you have to constrain yourself and relate to them in a language that they can understand, and then you can bring them into your world. So, you know, that song lends well. It's an easy vehicle. It's an accessible vehicle for that particular kind of thing.
Mm-hmm. Okay. We're going to take a break, but we'll be back in a couple of minutes to talk more with George Howard, right here on Video Soul. Welcome back to Video Soul. I'm Donnie Simpson. Once again, we are joined by George Howard. I got a chance to see George perform in Houston, Texas about 2 years ago, and it was one of the biggest shocks of my life, because here I'm going to a jazz concert, and I'm expecting a lot of old guys sitting around going, yeah, that's nice, And it was, everybody was up and partying, man. I mean, it was quite different from, I think, what a lot of people think jazz concerts are like. You have a lot of fun, don't you?
Well, you know, it's all music to me, and you know, the word jazz is a word, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of people will hear the word and they immediately turn off to the music, and they think of the old standards like Seven Steps to Heaven, you know. But you got to understand, I never called it jazz. That's what y'all call it. I just call it music.
Uh-huh.
And at the time, I'm living in the 80s and now in the 90s, so, you know, we're going to project what's happening. And We do like to have fun. We feed off the energy of the audience, man, and we throw down when we go out there.
I mean, if people were up, hand clapping, it was, I said, shoot, this is like a Rick James concert. We're really getting off. What, do you enjoy that a lot? I mean, do you get tired of the road, or do you still enjoy doing concerts?
I get tired of the road, the actual road, the airports, the hotels, you know. Living out of suitcases, leaving expensive shirts in the hotels and never getting them back. I get tired of that kind of stuff. You know, but the energy of the people, I can never get tired of that, because that's what makes it all worth it. And when I get there and they're pumped up and they're ready to hear something, no matter how tired we are, and we're definitely tired most of the time when we pull into a town, but we get that energy from the people, man. It's like, okay, we gotta suck it up one more time, and let's not let them down. And we just go out there and throw down, man.
How long are your tours generally?
Well, this one, I've been out for... how long have I been out, Donnie? I've been out for a month so far. I'll be out for 3 more weeks. Then we'll break for about 2 weeks, and then I go back out for 6 more weeks with George Duke and Stanley Clarke.
Wow.
Yeah, so that's going to be fun. I look forward to that.
Yeah, but yeah. That's a long time from home, man.
It is, man. It is.
Yeah. When do you get time to record? Do you record while you're on tour sometimes?
Oh, no. I don't like to. That, to me, that's like drinking and driving. Mm-hmm. You know, I like to do one or the other. I'm either on tour or I'm either making a record, because it's two different types of energy focuses. You know, mm-hmm. It's like I can't focus on an album and focus on keeping that energy up for the crowd every time I go out there, too, because that entails a lot more than just doing the show. Like, mm-hmm. You got to meet a lot of people, and you go to the stations in the market, you go to the store. So it's like, it takes a lot of energy. People think you're just having fun, and that all they see is that 1 hour and a half.
Right.
You know, or 90 minutes or 70 minutes, however long you play, but it's like a 24-hour gig, you know?
Mm-hmm. So. Who handles the producing on your album?
This last one, I worked with a lot of different people. I worked with George Duke, which is always a thrill to work with George. Because, I mean, George Duke is one person that I would trust completely with my direction, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And I worked with Larry Blackman. I worked with Preston Glass. We co-produced the tune. I co-produced the tune with Larry Blackman and Zane Giles, who I really enjoyed working with. But I was accustomed to producing my own albums, and I missed doing that, even though for the first time in my career, I got to be the artist and just go in and pick my horn up and play.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that was a relief in mm-hmm. a sense, because I really missed it. But it got to my ego too, because I was saying, wow, you know, I want to call the shots. You know, but it was great. I mean, I'm not saying that to be negative, because the people that I worked with were really good people to work with. And I learned a whole lot, especially from George. I always learned from George.
Yeah.
And I learned a lot from Zane Giles.
But why did you decide to work with producers this time instead of doing it yourself?
Because I was pretty tired. You know, mm-hmm. I had taken some time off, and you know, the train was moving a little too fast, so I just parked the train or got off the train and just took about a year and a half break. And coming right back from this hiatus, I didn't want to produce the album in its entirety.
Mm-hmm.
And at first there was a little struggle over what my direction was going to be, because there were a couple folks that saw me as a Bobby Brown with a horn, and I'm like, I'm not Bobby Brown, I'm George Howard, man, you know? And but I thought that would be the best thing to do, to meet a happy medium, to get what I wanted and to give them what they wanted, would be to just work with some different people and see what we come up with.
Yeah.
And oddly enough, everybody's gravitating to the kind of stuff that I had been doing throughout my career. You know, everybody's
like gravitating. Like the cut you just played, you and me.
Yeah, right. People are gravitating toward that, so I'm going to go back to producing my records again. Why not?
Hey, if it works, why not?
Hey, if it's not broke,
as many
no
weeks
fiction.
As I've seen you spend at the top of the charts.
Hey.
Why not? I mean, you've had some major successes.
If it's not broke, don't fix it, right?
That's right. I'm telling you. We want to do a show a video now. One of our sound engineers, Tony, just got married this weekend. We congratulate him and his wife. What's your name?
Tanya.
And this was the song that they used for their first dance after the wedding this past weekend. This is Shower You With Love. George Howard on Video Soul.
Oh, 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 yeah, yeah.
George Howard, Shower You With Love on Video Soul. Where'd you find this white guy that can sing like James Ingram? I mean, it. I'm sure everybody, when it first heard his voice, went, no, he ain't white. And then he showed the video and went, whoa, he's very soulful.
MCA did that. You know, they signed him, and basically that's what Lil Solace wanted. Mm-hmm. And I figured, that, hey, why not?
Yeah, John Pagano.
John
is
Pagano.
He's very talented. Is he out on the road with you?
No.
Oh, okay.
No.
So you do? Who do you get to sing the song when you're on the road?
Nobody.
Do you do the song when you're on the
road? We don't do the song.
You don't really?
Nah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I'm just curious to know why.
Well, you know, I'm a sax player.
Yeah.
And that's what I do. Yeah. And sometimes you put vocals on records to make it lend well to certain formats and what have you. But for me, no matter what I do on the record, when I go live, it's on me. It's my show. You know, it's like I'm the artist, and I feel that I have to deliver at what I do best. So I just throw down. I figure, like, I know a lot of people want to hear the song, but that makes me play even harder.
So that they won't think about it.
Yeah,
they won't even remember.
They walk away totally satisfied. It's not even a problem.
So when they do that, I mean, is that like under the direction of the record company, where they're trying to take it out of just the jazz arena and make it a pop album? So they'll do something like that with the vocals?
Record companies think in very funny ways, you know. And I never sit back and try to question their wisdom or their judgment. I just do what I do. I make a record, and I put it out there. And like when people receive it, that feels great. You know, I think that it was good for my project to work with someone like John, or to have a song like that on my album, because it's the kind of song that everybody can identify with and that everybody can relate to. And regardless of what the motive of the record company is, I have to feel good about what goes on my record. And if I don't feel good about it, it doesn't go on my record. So, you know, I stand behind it.
Okay.
Yeah.
What do you do in your spare time?
I don't have spare time,
man. Really? I mean, you don't get time to play basketball or...
Oh, well, yeah, I can run a little ball from time to time, but, you know, I get afraid to get my fingers jammed and somebody hit me in the mouth. You know, I don't want to play with any frustrated cat that got cut from some protein or something, throwing elbows.
Right. You've been watching the Pistons trying to get to be one of the bad boys.
I play with wimps, you know, soft passes.
And y'all play the old-fashioned way, right?
Yeah.
You jump center after every basket.
Right.
No fast break.
Somebody fouls, excuse me, are you okay?
So you play basketball, anything else?
Well, I like shoot pool. Like I told you, I'm going to come over your house and play you for your pool table.
Hey, come on. Yeah. What are you going to put up for my pool table?
I don't have to worry about that, Donnie, because I'm leaving with your pool table.
That'll be the only way you get it. You carry it on your back. And I already know you're scared of jamming your fingers, so I ain't going to worry too much about it.
Don't worry too much about it.
And I'd love to have you over to do that sometime,
cool.
Man.
Yeah, man.
We'll report the results right here on Video Soul.
I'm
sure we will. Unless I lose, then you got to buy air time. Because I won't talk about it. Thank you so much for being with
pleasure,
us again, man.
It's always good to see you, Dad.
It's always a pleasure. All George Howard on Video Soul. We'll be back in a couple of minutes. Don't go away. Up next on Video Soul, we've got Mickey Howard doing a great remake of the Aretha Franklin classic, which I didn't think anyone could do. Not like Aretha, but Mickey does it real well. I really like it a lot. It's called Until You Come Back to Me.
So you don't want to talk to me? Just don't even call me anymore. Oh, you don't call me anymore. I sit and wait in pain. I guess I'll rap on your door, tap on your window pane. Wanna tell you, babe, the changes.
Don't go away. We've got a little more Video Soul left. We'll be back in a couple of minutes. Barbara Weathers is a former member of the group Atlantic Star, and she's just released a brand new single from her upcoming album. It is called Master Key, and we have a look at it for you now right here on Video Soul. Barbara Weathers looking good in that bra. I mean, bustier. It's just a bra you pay $50 more for. We'll be back in a couple of minutes. Don't go away.